My name is Keshav Joshi. I'm here to talk to you today about the Indigenous Horse Owners Association.
My name is Ajay Nancy. I'm the chairman of the Indigenous Horse Owners Association.
My name is Harsh Lunia, and I'm a committee member on the IHOA Association.
To start an association in Maharashtra where like-minded folks who have Marwari horses or indigenous horses could have a platform on which to have multiple events and to increase our knowledge, share.
And our vision is to take the horse to the world and show him internationally as a horse which is capable of doing multiple sports.
We've made an indigenous horse event calendar for the year, for every year. We kicked it off with an endurance event. For the last 2 years, we were doing club level league events. And this year, the Equestrian Federation of India, the EFI, a body of India, has affiliated with us and given us the national tag.
There's a lot that goes into it. I mean, every horse owner, at least in our association, will have hands-on experience with his or her horses. It's a time-consuming activity, but one that I don't think anybody will regret spending time with their horses. And that's the kind of passion that goes in. I know people who've spent hours in their stables, if they have a horse that's ill, unwell, or just for the sake of it. People will wake up at 6 in the morning on Sunday and go play with their horses. So that's really where the passion is completely visible. The objective behind the association is primarily taking care of Marwari horses and improving the breed.
So to find a proper channel for the horse to be presented and to be used, we are trying to put the horse into a proper sport and a proper presentation to the world.
All our horses at all our shows or any event that we have to have mandatory tests done, blood tests done.
Basically, the motive behind doing this breed show is to bring out the best quality animal currently alive, which can be used for further sports prospect and be a proven good breeding animal or be a prospect breeding animal for the future. And we'll have a far better Marwari horse, which we can then put up on the national platform for competing within India and hopefully performs as per its expectations. And if we can convince our fellow members and the governments, maybe we can fly this over to other countries, to beyond boundaries, and compete at the international platforms as well. Where you're going to be able to witness all this and see is going to be at the RWITC Pune Turf Club on the 2nd and 3rd of March. The association in the last 3 years of eventing has grown so much that finally we've been allowed to bring the indigenous animal into the premises of the RWITC Pune. We are very overwhelmed and thankful to the RWITC for allowing the indigenous horse to begin its national presence from this 2019 onwards. March 2nd and 3rd, I hope you'll come and cheer the animal. This is our very own indigenous horse of India.